How about a question from Chad?
For me?
I don't know. Probably.
I haven't got a question for a while.
All right, my question really is about morality. So my question is, why would God send us here to Earth for a test to go to heaven or hell when he already knows what we're going to be since he knows the future?
That's a good question. So he sends us here so that we can find out for ourselves.
Yeah, but like he already knows the future.
Yes.
What's the point of us finding out?
So his knowledge isn't what's important, because you're right, he already knows the future. The question is, do we know? And that's what we're here to find out. And we can know, because he's told us how we can know. And the way we know is through the gospel. And it was what Shelley was talking about, how we do things that we shouldn't do, we know that we shouldn't do, and those are bad things. The Christians call it sin.
Yeah.
And that sin, in light of how good God is, that sin is really bad. It's so bad, in fact, that God would have the right to actually to put us to death because of that sin. But instead what he does is he allows us to make a free choice to accept what Jesus did on the cross, so that Jesus would take the price that we should have paid, and from that then we can come into a right relationship with God, and through that right relationship with God we can enjoy eternal life with him. And that's what flourishing really is about. So if we can agree, Bernie and I can agree on that as being the definition of flourishing, then yes, we're all for that. So it's not about God knowing, it's about us knowing.
Yeah,
and actually
us knowing. But like, there's some people that are born in North Korea,
mm-hmm.
in prison camps, and
mm-hmm.
don't even, or like, let's say Africa, and
mm-hmm.
are raised as a Muslim for their whole life,
mm-hmm.
or under a dictator, and they don't even have a chance to know about Jesus, or have never even heard about that Jesus in their whole lifetime.
Well, I know that God is the ultimate fair being. He is perfect. So somehow he's fair in what comes out. So in the case of like North Korea, actually a lot of North Koreans do find out about Jesus, and they do come to know him, and amazingly they escape that terrible place, and they can flourish.
No, they're brainwashed over there.
And I would agree that that is really bad. And the people who
brainwash to serve the supreme leader.
Yeah.
They pretty much worship him as a god.
I know. I've seen the video, and it really is bad. And I agree that's an example of objective evil. So I believe that what the dictators in North Korea are doing is really wrong. And I believe that a just God would make sure that the people that do that really wrong stuff actually have to pay for that. And that's what justice is all about. On the same time, he's gracious enough that even those people that do those really bad things can accept Christ's forgiveness. And even the leaders there, believe it or not, if they truly repent and truly say, I'm sorry for what I did, it was wrong, then they too.
But what about the victims? Like, the ones that probably never, like, in the prison camps, like, starving to death as a child born there, and they start in the prison camps.
Yeah, what about them?
Like, how are they supposed to know about Jesus? Are they given a trial or what?
Well, either they'll learn about him some way, or from creation. The Bible says that even through creation, what we can see in creation testifies to the truth that God exists. That we have a conscience that tells us right and wrong, that testifies that God exists. And if we acknowledge that, even if we don't know specifically the name Jesus, if we trust in God that he is merciful, that even if we don't really know him as Jesus and don't understand exactly how that works, or maybe if we're a little kid and we don't really understand complex theology and all this, we can still be saved. And we can still have a relationship with him that is great in this life and helps us flourish now, but more importantly, it helps us flourish forever and ever. And that is true flourishing. And that's what Christians believe.
Okay, just one little follow-up comment on there. He asked about why people are born if God already knows what's going to happen to them. He already knows everything about it, so why even go through it? And you said, because we need to go through it. Mm-hmm. And I was thinking, well, what about women? The natural miscarriage rate is so high, it's like 70% or something, that women have miscarriages and didn't even know they were pregnant. And then, of course, all the children that die, even under 1 year old. So why would they be born? I mean, they had no chance. You make it sound like it's about us, but all these people died without even being aware of that they're alive.
Well, it's very plausible that miscarried children go straight to heaven. So maybe they're the most flourishing of us all. And maybe what we see as...
What would they be in heaven, like a 30-year-old? I mean, they wouldn't even have a brain.
No, I think it works differently in heaven because humans aren't all about their chronological maturity. They're about the fact that they're human.
Okay. All right, so who's next?